After billions of years of single-celled life, something amazing happened in the deep sea. Increased oxygen enables some cells to stick together. Some of these clumps ultimately evolved into animals. To find out how oxygen drove this process, I have come to Australia's Barrier Reef to look at one of the most primitive of animals alive today, one that can truly be called a living fossil. It's one of the simplest multi-celled organisms that we know, but its basic body structure has nonetheless enabled it to survive virtually unchanged for around 600 million years. It's a sponge. Sponges are just collections of simple cells that have clumped together and got stuck together. They don't have a digestive system or a nervous system or a blood circulatory system, and they get their food and their oxygen by just pumping seawater through channels in the body. But they can give us an indication of how it was that cells first clumped together to form bodies of any real size. At the microscopic level, sponge cells are bound together by a tangle of hairy, stringy protein molecules called collagen. This collagen glue is found only in animals and nowhere else. Collagen is sometimes called the sticky tape of the animal world. It's the commonest protein in our body. It forms the framework of our skins. Plastic surgeons use it to pump up our lips. You need oxygen to manufacture collagen. And with the rising amount of oxygen in the atmosphere at the end of Snowball Earth, cells were able to manufacture it.